Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is November 29th, 2019. This is my 36th episode about linear algebra and threading building blocks. In this episode, I will implement algorithm for linear dependence of vectors. In episode 37, I will implement algorithm for linear dependence of matrix. And episode 38, I will parallelize the algorithm. Currently, I use Sohm's Outline of Linear Algebra, 5th edition, this book, to implement my algorithms. In this book, at section 4.7, Linear Dependence and Independence. So basically, I am dealing this part of the text. In chapter 4, Vector Space also deals linear dependence in R3. In my previous episode, I said the biggest challenge is not solving the problem, but recognizing the problem. The concept of linear dependence and independence is very important. Let me read this part of text. Let V a vector space of a field K. The following defines the notion of linear dependence and independence of vectors over K. This concept plays an essential role in the theory of linear algebra and in mathematics in general. For some people, linear dependence or independence is a trivial matter, may never concern about third things, but for me, it's important. So, through episode 36, through episode 38, I will implement linear dependence algorithm. I will put this script in the description section. By clicking this link, you can download the source code from our previous episode, episode 35. Show in folder, unzip it, right click, rename, 36 linear dependence vector. Now copy the folder name, copy, paste it to your working folder. This is my working folder. Start Visual Studio Code. Open the folder. Right-click template.cpp, copy, select folder 36, right-click, paste, right-click, rename, linear, vctr.cpp, hit enter. Control V, so, in the step 0, we recognized our problem. Step 1, we analyze the problem. Step 2, we implement simple but correctly working algorithm. It does not need to be optimized as long as it works correctly and should be simple. To reflect our analysis at step 1. Step 3, we will optimize our algorithm created in step 2 above. Step 4, we can sort out parallelizable paths from our sequential algorithm created in step 3. But in this episode, we will not to step 4. So, in step 0, we recognized our problem. In step 1, we will analyze the problem. In step 2, we will implement a simple but correctly working algorithm. It does not need to be optimized as long as it works correctly and should be simple. To reflect our analysis at step 1. We will optimize our algorithm created in step 2 above. We will sort out parallel paths from our sequential algorithm created in step 3. But in this episode, we will not parallelize our algorithm. For the test linear dependence, I will copy the function name and paste it in the function main. For any two vectors A and B in three space over a field K if there exists two scalars A and B, not all of them are zero, such that A times A plus B times B equals 0, 0, 0, the zero vector. Then we say vector A and B are linearly dependent. For example, using element T double, using vector T matrix, scalable fast vector element T, vector T A1, 1, 2, 3, vector T B1, 2, 4, 6, vectors A1 and B1 are linearly dependent because 2 times A1 plus negative 1 times B1 equals 0, 0, 0. In this case, both 2 and negative 1 are not 0. This is mathematical definition of linear dependence. For more information, please refer to section 4.7 in this book. I will fix this part. For the sake of brevity, we will denote zero vector in three space by zero. So A times A plus B times B equals zero. Not all of them are zero, means that at least one of A and B is not zero. If A is not zero, A times A plus B times B equals zero. I will copy and paste, then plus minus B times B plus minus B times B. I copy once again. This part becomes zero, and this part becomes this. From this, we can arrange it like this. Since A is not zero, A inverse times A times A equals A inverse times minus B times B. We multiplied A inverse to both sides of this equation because A is not zero and its inverse exists in field K. So 1 times A equals A inverse times negative B times B. So A equals negative B over A times B. Or we can say A equals K times B, where K equals minus B over A. In the same manner, if B is not zero, B equals minus a over b times a, or b equals k prime times a, where k prime equals negative a over b. I will refine our definition, mathematical definition of linear dependence of two vectors A and B in three space over a field K. Let's scroll down. Since A is not zero, A has its multiplicative inverse, and we denote it by A hat minus 1. A has its multiplicative inverse in K. From this equation, A equals K times B, or B equals K prime times A. In a nutshell, two vectors A and B are linearly dependent if one can be represented as a scalar multiple of the other, as below. A equals K times B, or B equals K prime times A. This equation and this equation are equivalent for our C++ implementation. We will use this equation. In component wise, A0, A1, A2 equals K times B0, B1, B2. Or A0 equals K times B0, A1 equals K times B1, A2 equals K times B2. Or we can say K equals A0 over B0 equals A1 over B1 equals A2 over B2. If such K exists in the field K, then two vectors A and B are linearly dependent. I will label this equation base condition. Now, condition 1, if AI is not 0 and VI equals 0 for some I in 0, 1, 2, now scroll down. For example, vector T, A2, 1, 2, 3, vector T, B2, 0, 4, 6, B2, 0, is 0, A2, 0, is not 0. In such case, there exists no such A and B in K such that A times A2 plus B times B2 equals 0. So vector A2 and vector B2 are not linearly dependent. I scroll up. If AI is not 0 and VI is 0 for some I in 0, 1, 2, then A is not linearly dependent. with B. This is condition 1. Condition 2. If AI is 0 and BI is 0 for some I in 0, 1, 2. Now scroll down. Vector T A3 0, 2, 3. Vector T B3 0, 4, 6. B 0 equals 0. A 0 equals 0. A3, B3. In such case, we can ignore AI 0 and BI 0 for some I in 0, 1, 2. And we have to further test for other elements of A and B. I will fix like this. In this case, A3 and B3 are linearly dependent. And I will give you another example. I faced it. A4 and B4. For example, 1, A3 and B3 are linearly dependent. But A4 and B4 are not linearly dependent. A4, B4. So, scroll up. We ignore AI over BI. If both AI and BI are 0, and we have to further test with other elements of A and B. Condition 3. If AI is not 0 and BI is not 0 for all I in 0, 1, 2 and there exists K such that I will copy this equation. Then A and B are linearly dependent. This is condition 3, where AI is not 0 and BI is not 0. So we collected condition 1, condition 2, and condition 3. Now we completed our analysis, step 1. And please pause this video and think about condition 1, condition 2, and condition 3. Let's take a coffee break. Now we will implement step 2, a simple but correctly working algorithm. For Microsoft C++ compiler, we have to define no min-max. This is for Microsoft compiler. Now scroll down. Template, type name, vector type A, type name, vector type B, type name, vector type A, equal talk play fun, remove constant reference T, vector type A, type name, vector type B, equal talk play fun, remove constant reference T, vector type B, or both vector matrix is vector B, vector type A, and matrix is vector B, vector type B, using enable if vectors T std enable if t both vectors. I say both vectors. So I defined a type alias called enable if vectors t. Template type name vector type A, type name vector type B, type name enable if vectors t vector type A vector type B. Auto draft quotient vector vector type A, A vector type B, B std vector double quotients. We will initialize the size A size. Context peer, I will use another type alias using element T matrix vector element T talk play fun remove constant reference T vector type A element T improbable std numeric limits element T max for size T I less than A size plus plus I if AI equals 0 and BI is not 0. I will copy once again or faced BI is not 0, AI is 0, then quotient I equals double 0. This part forms condition 0. Okay? A is not linearly dependent with B. Condition 0. A is not linearly dependent with B. Else if AI equals 0 and BI equals 0, quotient I double improbable. So this condition forms condition 2. I say improbable. Means A and B are not linearly dependent. I will put 0. Condition 1. We need further test with remaining elements of A and B. Else, both AI and BI are not 0. So, quotient I equals AI over BI. Now, return quotients. We created a simple vector, and here I will copy this part, copy, paste, and rename it draft is vectors linearly dependent. Auto quotients. We call this function paste std forward vector type A std forward vector type B for size T I less than quotients size. I say A size plus plus I will copy this part, copy and paste it here. I will delete this. If quotients I equals improbable, it means A and B are not linearly dependent. Return false. Not linearly dependent, else if coefficients I equals 0, we need further test. Continue. Else double k, if k equals 0, k equals coefficients I. Else if k is not equal to coefficients I, return false. After for loop, return true. Linearly dependent. So this is our draft implementation. Now copy this function, scroll down here, stream A, and L. This is A1. This is B1, stream A1 and B1 linearly dependent. Faced. I will copy this function. Copy. Faced. A1, B1, and there. Now I will copy this part once again. Copy. Faced it here. A2, B2, A2, B2, A2, B2, A2, B2. I will copy once again. Copy. Faced it here. A3, B3, A3, B3, A3, B3, A3, B3. Faced it here once again. A4, B4, A4, B4, A4, B4, A4, B4. Now double check. A1, A1, B1, B1, A1, B1, A1, B1. Now start command prompt. DIR, CD36, linear dependence vector. Clang plus plus, STD, C++17, linear, VCTR.cpp, LTVV, LTVV, MALLOC, hit enter. CLS. So, A1, B1 are linearly dependent, true. A2, B2, linearly dependent, false. Yes, this is not linearly dependent, this is correct. In this case, A3, B3, linear dependent, true. A4, B4 are linearly dependent, false. So everything works perfectly. I scroll up. This is condition 1. And this is condition 2. And this is condition 3 that we analyzed here. This is condition 1 when AI is not 0, BI is 0. Condition 2, both AI and BI are 0. Condition 3, all of AIs and BIs are not 0. Also understand that is vector V. This type function matrix is vector B, and vector element T, this type function are defined through episode 26 type function 1 and episode 27 type function 2 and episode 28 type function 3. Through these three videos, we defined type functions. I will copy and paste it here for your reference. Like this. Another thing you should note that this vector are of type real. vector space of real number field R. For vector space of a complex number, I will implement in my next episode. Now we completed step 2. Now let's think about step 3. I will copy from here draft quotient vector, scroll down up to this point, copy, I make demarcation, faced, scroll up, I will change the function name intermediate, like this. If A size is not equal to B size, then return quotients. I will copy this line, cut, and paste it here. I will modify this line, and here quotients resize A dot size. Also scroll down. This is condition 1, not linearly dependent. Then I will delete this line, return quotients. The remainder is the same. Now scroll down. I will also modify this function name, intermediate. Here, if quotients size is not equal to A size, return false. Now scroll down. I can also modify this part like this and scroll down. I will copy this part, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, Ctrl K, Ctrl C. I will indent. It should be intermediate. Scroll down. I will copy this part, paste, Ctrl K, Ctrl C. I will indent. It should be intermediate. Scroll down. I will copy this part, paste. It should be intermediate. And I will disable this part, Ctrl K, Ctrl C. I will indent, scroll down. I will copy this part, Ctrl C, Ctrl V. I will disable this part, Ctrl K, Ctrl C. I will indent. This is intermediate. Now we start. Command prompt again, we rebuild A. So it works exactly the same, but it is optimized. Finally, I will copy this function up to this point. Scroll down. I make demarcation faced, and I rename the function is linearly dependent. I will remove this part, and we don't need this. We return false, and this part is continue. And in this part, if k equals 0, k equals AI over BI. We haven't defined K. I will delete this. Double K. Else if K is not equal to, I will copy this part. Return false. So this is our final version. Now copy this. Linearly dependent. Scroll down. I will overwrite. So I modified like this. Now we build again. 174. 174. It should be false. Sorry, it should be true. I modified like this. CLS. So A1, B1, linearly dependent true. A2, B2, linearly dependent false. A3, B3, linearly dependent true. A4, B4, linearly dependent false. So this final version is optimized. Please note that this linearly dependent function supports vector space over real number field R. In my next episode, 37, vector space over complex number field. This is episode 38, episode 39. In future episode, I will extend this linear dependence algorithm for vector space over complex number field and also linear dependence of matrix of real numbers, also complex numbers. Then we will parallelize our linear dependence algorithm for matrices of real numbers and complex numbers. Through this episode, I hope you understand how I approach the solution to our problems. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.